Today we will discuss about the chloroplast. Always we will say that chloroplast is green in color. Chloroplast will be having a capacity to store energy or trap sunlight. So what is a chloroplast? So even if you don't know from your earlier classes, now you can get. So when we take any green color leaf, why green color leaf? Only in green color leaves chloroplast is present. And what about other leaves here? In white color leaf, any other color leaves, leucoplasts are present, or chromoplast, leucoplast or chromoplast is present. But we don't have that syllabus in our, we don't have that topic in our syllabus. Knowing knowledge is okay. Leucoplast means colorless leaves. Chromoplast means other than green, all colored leaves, like bouquets when you find that. So when we take green color leaf, then in that term, we can find some of the organelles which are green in color. In fact, they will give green color to the leaf. So those are called as chloroplast. So they are cell organelles first. They are cell organelles. Second one, they trap in solar energy, that means sun energy, sun rays. Third one, they help in photosynthesis. Fourth one, they participate in light and dark reactions. Light and dark reactions. So these are the important, most important functions of a chloroplast. First, it is a cell organelle which gives green color to the leaf. Next one, it traps the solar energy or sun energy and helps in photosynthesis. They also participate in light and dark reactions. Photosynthesis is a light type of a light reaction only. So these are the four important functions of a chloroplast. Then we will discuss about the structure of chloroplast. In your SSC exam, definitely there will be a question on this chloroplast. Explain a double membrane organelle which helps in photosynthesis. That means chloroplast. You need to remember, chloroplast has a double membrane. Double membrane is present. How? Here you can see. Two membranes are present, first one, second one. So this is a double membrane structure and having oval shape. You can see this is having oval shape, complete oval shape. Then we will come first part, upper membrane and the lower membrane. So you can see two membranes are there, upper membrane and lower membrane. Next, it consists of a dark region called as a stroma. So wherever this region you can see this empty region, it is called as a stroma, that is this dark region where sunlight is not received. Whereas in case of grana, you can see these regions will receive sunlight. That's why it is called as a solar trapping region. This region it is called as solar trapping region. So with the help of sun rays, first they will fall on it. Sun rays will fall on these regions. Whenever sunlight falls on this region, then it forms a trapping of solar energy. Then one more part, you can see it is grana thylakoids. Grana thylakoids means here like membranes will be formed. These are called as thylakoids. These will store sunlight energy and then it helps in photosynthesis. So these are like a packed batteries which store sun's energy and helps in preparation of food materials. And one more thing, it is this coiled structure, spring-like structure, it is called as a starch grain. And then you can see here some of the darkly placed objects are there. These are called as fat globule, that means fats. We will have a groundnut oil, sunflower oil, rice bran oil, olive oil. So these oils are produced by these lipid globules. So that will help in storage, preparation of oils. So this is about chloroplast. Chloroplast is a pigment which have a implementing, it gives a green color for every green plant. White gives, it consists of magnesium. You have to remember, magnesium is the chief element which gives green in color for the chloroplast, and magnesium is present in chlorophyll. Understood? So simply to say that this is a leaf, inside that chloroplast is present and in that thylakoid membranes are present, inside that chlorophyll is present. Chlorophyll consists of an element called as magnesium. This will give green color. Understood? Leaf, inside the leaf chloroplast, inside the chloroplast chlorophyll. So chlorophyll consists of magnesium, that will give green color. Same like that, humans, inside that blood is present, inside blood hemoglobin, it is also a pigment that consists of iron, that will give red color. So for us, blood will be in red color due to iron present in hemoglobin, present in blood, present in our body. Same like that, green color is given by magnesium, which is present in chlorophyll, and then it is present in case of chloroplast, and then it is present within the cell. So this is about chloroplast. So in your exam, they will ask for 2 marks or otherwise for 4 marks. For 4 marks, they are asking means you need to write theories. This is a sunlight region. This is a dark region, and it consists of stroma thylakoid and granite thylakoids. Stroma thylakoids are very very narrow. Granite thylakoids are bundled here, and these are fat globules. This is a starch grain. Here the name is starch grain. And this is the double membrane, upper membrane and lower membrane. So this you need to explain for 4 marks. 2 marks means you can draw a diagram, and this also you need to explain. So leaf chloroplast is present as an organelle, inside that chlorophyll is present. So this is about chloroplast. Write neatly in your book and maintain the rules in drawing biology diagrams. You must not draw randomly. Rules will be there. So in physics means scaling work will be there, but in biology it is most important to put some rules to draw the diagram. So how it is there, the membrane, and how the thylakoid membranes are there, starch granules are there, same you need to draw like that in your book.